Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see what are the various examples that means designing of Weinbridge oscillator by using a frequency of oscillation or by using a various component value. This topic also covers to determine whether the circuit can provide oscillations at the output or not. So let's begin with the topic. We know that oscillator is an AC signal generator circuit. It is basically an amplifier which uses positive feedback and produces the output signal, that means oscillations at the output without any AC input signal. For obtaining the sustained oscillation, the circuit required to have a power supply. So as long as the DC power supply is available, the oscillator circuit produces output, but it uses a positive feedback. Now, let's see what are the various examples that are based on Weinbridge circuit. We know that in case of Weinbridge circuit, the frequency of oscillation is depend upon the value of resistors and capacitor. The Weinbridge circuit basically consists of four arms, the arm AB having serial combination of resistor and capacitor, second arm having parallel combination of resistor and capacitor, the third and fourth arm consist of two resistors, that means R3 and R4, which are used to provide a reference voltage. This reference voltage is remain constant and do not have any effect on the frequency. But the value of R3 can be used to change gain of the amplifier circuit. Now the frequency of oscillator is depend upon one of the arm that is called as frequency sensitive arm, which uses a parallel combination of R and C. So the formula which is used for frequency of oscillation can be given by F is equals to 1 upon 2 pi RC. So simply by changing the value of R and C, we can vary the frequency of oscillations of the oscillator circuit. The second condition that required to be satisfied by the circuit or to have a sustained oscillation is related to gain. As op-amp is used in non-inverting configuration, because the Weinbridge circuit does not introduce any phase shift, that means the phase shift introduced by Weinbridge circuit is equals to 0 degree. So to satisfy the first condition of Barkhausen's criteria, that is the total phase shift around the loop is required to be 0 degree or 360 degree or integral multiple of 360 degree. As Weinbridge network does not introduce any phase shift, therefore we require to use an amplifier which also introduces a phase shift of 0 degree. That's why the non-inverting amplifier configuration of op-amp is used. So in that case, the gain of op-amp is given by a formula A equals to 1 plus R3 by R4. That is the formula for gain of non-inverting configuration of op-amp. The feedback network, that means the Weinbridge network, having a feedback factor beta equals to 1 by 3. So as per Barkhausen's criteria, that means the second criteria, which says that the mod of A beta is required to be greater than 1. Therefore, to satisfy this criteria, we have the value of beta as 1 by 3. Therefore, the gain of op-amp is required to be greater than 3. That's why A required to be greater than 3. So whenever the circuit satisfied this condition, then only it can provide sustained oscillation. Now let's see the first problem related to the Weinbridge oscillator designing circuit. The statement of problem is, for Weinbridge oscillator, R equals to 5.1 kilo ohms, C equals to 1 nanofarad, R3 equals to 12 kilo ohms and R4 equals to 5.1 kilo ohms. Determine whether the circuit will oscillate or not. Second, find the output frequency. Now in this case, the values of resistors and capacitors are given and we need to first determine whether the circuit can oscillate, and second, we need to find out the operating frequency. So first, let's write down a given data. we know that in order to have a circuit to provide a sustained oscillation, it is very much important that the gain of the circuit is required to be greater than 3. So first, let's find out gain of circuit by using a formula 1 plus R3 by R4. Value of R3 is 12 kilo ohms and R4 is 5.1 kilo ohms. Value of R3 is 12 kilo ohms and value of R4 is 5.1 kilo ohms. So we will obtain value of gain as 3.35. In order to have a sustained oscillation or the circuit to oscillate, the gain is required to be greater than 3. Here we obtain value of gain as 3.35, therefore the circuit will oscillate. So the answer for the first problem is to determine whether the circuit will oscillate or not is, as gain is greater than 3, the circuit will definitely provide sustained oscillations. The second part of the problem is to find out operating frequency. The operating frequency is depend upon the value of R and C, and it is given by the formula. F equals to 1 upon 2 pi R and C. In the problem, the values of R and C are given. Therefore, let's substitute the value and find out the operating frequency F. So we obtain operating frequency as 31.2 kHz. So in this way, we can find out the operating frequency, and by finding out gain, we can determine whether the circuit can produce sustained oscillation or not. Now let's move to the second problem that is related to the designing of Wien bridge oscillator using op-amp. And the statement of problem is, design Wien bridge oscillator for frequency of 1 kHz. Here, values of components are not given, but the frequency of oscillation is given. Therefore, first we need to assume the value of capacitor, and then by using the assumed value of capacitor and given value of frequency, we can find out the value of resistor R. So, let's assume the value of capacitor as 0.01 microfarad. As we know, the formula for frequency is F equals to 1 upon 2 pi RC. So, by using frequency and capacitor value, we can write down the same formula in other form. That is, R equals to 1 upon 2 pi FC. So we obtain value of R as 15.91 kilo ohms. As we get the value of R and C, the next step is to determine the values of feedback components, that means R3 and R4, so that we can design an op-amp circuit. We know that to have a sustained oscillation, the amplifier circuit required to satisfy the condition, that is A is always greater than equals to 3. So A is nothing but gain of amplifier, and op-amp is connected in non-inverting configuration. Therefore, formula for gain is 1 plus RF by R1, that is 1 plus R3 by R4. In order to have sustained oscillation, A is greater than or equals to 3, that is 1 plus R3 by R4 is equals to 3. So if we substitute the values or if we shift the term, then we will get R3 by R4 is equals to 2, and therefore R3 is equals to R4. Now let's assume the value of R3 as 10 kilo ohm so that we can get the value of R4. So when we assume the value of R4 as 10 kilo ohms, then we will obtain R3 as 20 kilo ohms. Or else we can assume R3 and we can easily calculate the value of R4. Or else we can assume R3 or we can easily calculate R4. So this is what about the designing problem of Wien bridge oscillator by using op-amp. So I hope you understand the topic of examples based on Wien bridge oscillator. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.